cool. So let's get started. I titled this "Stop Living So Carelessly." You know, just about 30 minutes ago or so, I was outside shooting some hoops, and I recognized that I was missing every shot. And look, I grew up playing basketball. Now, the point of the story is that I was in my mind as I'm doing an activity that I enjoy. And you see, when you're in your mind, you're no longer living your life. Take a moment. You see, if I were to be playing basketball and I'm noticing that I'm missing every shot, I'm not in tune, I'm not in the frequency of this activity, my vibe is off. Have you ever had your vibe off? Let's say if you're a real estate agent and you're making cold calls, but something inside, there's like this resistance. You could just feel it. There's this substance inside of us that is resisting that activity. And we can analyze it. We're in our mind. We're not existing in the activity, but we're in this virtual reality called the mind. And what I wanted to say is that we gotta just start loving the fuck out of our life, man. We just truly got to start loving this thing, man. Because truth be told is that we're living on leased time, borrowed time. Like, how many of us know when the fuck our time is up in this planet? Like, really though. Like, legitly, take a moment to look. How do we know when our last moment, our last breath in this life is gonna be? So why the fuck are we carrying ourselves so lightly, so carelessly? My friends, we need to start carrying ourselves very big. When the mind starts creating these false narratives and these false illusions, and we start to have conversations in our mind as if they're existing. My friends, that's your mind. It's not existing. You're having conversations in your mind. Have you ever had the thought of like missing somebody, and you're, you know, talking in your mind about how you would talk to them because you have this feeling about them and you miss them? And instead of picking up the phone and sending out communication, you talk about it in your mind. How many times have we seen someone, or have you, you know, had an idea about starting a business or talking about your business or creating new ideas and going and putting the action behind it? How many times did you just stay in your mind and talk about it? You kept it in your mind until the energy dissipated and the energy of inspiration was no longer there. You see, we lost our life in that moment. And I'm fucking tired of my mind, especially when it's going negative. Look, I have this new offense alert in my system now that when my mind starts going negative, I take huge motherfucking offense. Why? Because I'm here to love my life. I'm not here to waste another fucking moment analyzing and thinking and having these stupid ass negative talk communication in my mind. I'm here to enjoy this. I'm here to set my tent, put the poles on the floor, and just look at the sky, look at the view, and just fully bask in the ecstasy of existence. We're so caught up in the day-to-day bullshit. So caught up in, we gotta do this, we gotta go here, we gotta do that, blah, 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 blah. Your mind is just bombarded, like, fucking stop. Mind, just shut up for a fucking second. Let me just embrace that the sun is out. It's sunny in San Jose, California. There's a nice gust of wind. I have this full breath. I can communicate to the world. I can just truly enjoy that I'm alive, right? And that's a huge... It's such a huge realization when you realize that, look, this time that we have here is temporary, and we just gotta fully accept. We gotta fully love everything you got going on right now. My friends, if you have no money right now, if you're struggling with something, if you're going through so much shit, it seems as if life is just shitting on you. My friends, fall in love with that. Fall in love with that. I tell you, one way when the world is fucking you, one way to tell you the world to go fuck itself is by just falling in love with everything it could give you. Show that you're a character that's unbreakable, that when the good and the bad come, that you stay true to you, that nothing can deviate you outside of your own center, outside of your own harmony, outside of your own frequency. And the only way you achieve that is by fully accepting the good and the bad. Understanding that the more you have of something, the more the opposite pull of that hurts. You see, it's like the more we love somebody, the more that betrayal is gonna hurt. The more you trust somebody, the more that backstab is gonna fucking create a wound in your back. But see, I don't wanna live a life not experiencing those things, afraid of those things, because my mind is afraid of getting hurt, because my heart is afraid of getting hurt. Motherfucker, my heart's been broken many times, and even if I try to resist that, it's still fucking broken. Right? So let's stop robbing myself of this experience and go fully with it. I learned to trust around me. Why? Because if I can trust me, if I can trust that I'm a good human being, if I can trust that everything I do when I show up to the arena of life is of good intent, of genuine act, of values and virtues, that when I show up to the arena of life, I can trust that I'm a good citizen of the universe. I'm a good representation of it, right? And we carry these as values to keep ourselves safe from the bullshit out there. But it has to start from inside, my friends. And it starts with the perspective that we just fully own our lives. We just fully accept everything that's going on. No matter what, no matter what. It's easy, it's easy. I'm telling you, it's so fucking easy. It's just a thought. And sometimes you don't even recognize you're in the thought of going negative. Take huge offense of going negative. Huge offense when your mind goes sour. Huge offense when you act out of character. Why? Because that's not your character. There's a goodness inside of you that's also inside of me. Now let's live by that. Let's honor that in ourselves. Let's love that about ourselves. That the world, no matter what's going on out there, I can't control what's going on out there. But I can control how I act towards this world and how I act within myself. Okay? And so that's it for this video vlog. Look, I have a program called Eye of the Tiger. It's a cardio boxing series. It's a set of workouts, one for every weekday, that if you took on the challenge of working on your body and pushing yourself through a set of 30-minute sessions of cardio boxing, staying engaged, staying fit, staying active, and really giving it all you got, I guarantee your energy levels in life to achieve and fulfill everything you desire will unlock, because we know that the truth is that we only perform as good as our own state of mind and our bodies are, okay? The spirit follows where there's inspiration with the source, okay? The source is you, my friend. You are the source. You are the light. But we begin to exchange in this world. So I've gone through many lessons, many trials and tribulations in my world. I've conquered many Goliaths. And motherfucker, I've been the David, okay? So I created a program called Eye of the Tiger Cardio Boxing. It's one for every weekday. It's a great program. It's on my website. You can find it at thefernandocaro.com if you want to take on an at-home workout that's very challenging, very enriching, and very, very fulfilling. And I'm very proud of that product. So I hope you guys all get a copy. Next week, the price will go up. Right now, we're still in an early bird special at $57. It's 100% worth it. I got a Telegram group as well where everybody is positive, keeps each other accountable. And every day, I post videos on there as well. And right now it's important to be a part of something powerful, something inspiring, okay? There's a lot of negativity out in the world, and that's why I'm doing these videos, okay? And at the same time, we're here to help and exchange, so I leave that for you guys, and I'll see you guys soon. Salute, ciao.